Through the streets, welcoming me back. Most days, it's thin enough so that you can breathe deep without coughing up something wet. Today, though, it's what you call a gray out. You choke with every breath. Your chest feels tight. Can't see much past your fingertips. I want to run. There's nowhere to run to. The gray feels like it's closing in on me, crushing me, smothering me. These are the times that I pray to Jana. Not everyone in Zaun believes she's real, but my mother always had faith. She told me a blue hovered outside her window on the day of my birth, and she knew it was Jana. It was Jana telling her I was going to be fine. She was wrong, of course. I wasn't fine in the end. A couple years ago, my mother, died while some scraping, and I had to raise myself with a few gears she left me. Then, the usual, I couldn't make any friends, got beaten up a lot. Boy I loved didn't love me back. I tried to study, tried to think my way up to Piltover. Couldn't. Figured Jana had forgotten about me. But I still gave me a wooden engraving depicting the bluebird she saw, just in case of moments like these. So I sit on the wet ground because I don't care enough to find a bench, and I take out the bluebird pendant I always keep tucked in my shirt, and I talk to Jana. Not out loud, of course. Some chem-burned freak, but I still don't. Just small, cautious grasp, but deep breaths that fill my lungs with cold, fresh air. No longer veiled in gray, the sun shines past the towers of the built-over into Sun itself. I can see the built-ovens above peering down at us. Without the gray clouding their view, they can see us from their lofty bridges and balconies. I don't think they like it very much. No one wants to be reminded they live above a slum. I see a few scowls. And that's when I see him again. Boswell Halloran, holding a sweet cake in his hands, looking down at me, an expression disgust on his face, just like before. I'm so busy staring at his contemptuous face that I don't notice the presence behind me until her hand is on my shoulder. "It's okay," she says, and I know without turning who it is. She squeezes my shoulder, and crosses her arms in front of my chest, pulling me into a hug. "It's gonna be okay," she says. Strands of her hair fall onto my shoulders. She smells like the air after a long rain. "It might not be okay now. You might and glides past me. For the first time, I see her in her entirety, a tall, ethereal figure Shinachina just touched me. I now notice her long, pointed ears, feet that don't touch the ground, hair flowing in the wind, even right now where there isn't any, eyes so blue, I feel a little cold just looking at her. But then she smiles and winks and says, this next part. There's a massive gust of wind so fast and sharp I have to cover my eyes. When I open them again, she's gone, but the wind is still blowing. It blows up toward Piltover and its gawking citizens. It whistles as it picks up speed. Strength, and the Pilties run for cover, but it's too late. The breeze hits them full force, sending their frocks sailing and musing their hair. Boswell Holleran shrieks in terror as the wind launches him off the balcony. It seems as though he's about to plummet towards certain death, but another gust of wind shoots up towards him, and his descent slows significantly, as if the wind is guiding him down. You wouldn't know it to look at him, though. Even though he's falling with all the velocity of a tumbling leaf, he screams the entire way down, very high-pitched, very undignified. His clothes flap upward, smacking him in the face as he descends, until he's hovering a few inches above a puddle. He begins before the wind disappears altogether, and he plops ass first into the puddle, ruining what I assume is a very expensive ensemble. He yells in a mixture of surprise, pain, and irritation, splashing around like an angry child. He tries to get to his feet, only to slip back down all over again. If I'm being completely honest, he looks like an idiot, and I can't stop laughing. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please do me a favor and like and subscribe. And let me know in the comments down below whose story you'd like to hear next.